Hi, this is David Jackel on behalf of Expert Village, and I'm here to talk to you about converting MIDI files to audio files in GarageBand. Now, the reason you would want to take a MIDI file and convert it to an audio file is that it's much less of a drain on your computer. Because MIDI files are completely software instruments, they're much more complex, they eat up memory, and they slow down a song. When you settle on how you want the MIDI file to be, convert it into an audio file to make it much less of a drain on your computer. So let's say I want to add just another loop, but I don't want it to be as a MIDI file. What I do is I go into GarageBand, select Preferences, go into Loops up here, and where it says Adding Loops to Timeline, I select Convert to Real Instrument. Okay, now let's try it out. So there's this loop right here that I want to use. Okay, so I click it, I drag it over here, and now as you can see, it's blue, not green. Green means MIDI, blue means real audio. And that way, as I continue to add loops, I can do so in a way that isn't going to slow down my computer and make it freeze. So once you settle on how you want your MIDI part to go, use this technique to make things easier on your computer.